Ever since Autumn Restore 2's release, Risa continuously pushed out mostly minor updates and content extensions featuring new tracks and cars to add more variety to their creation. This weekend, the first of three parts of the Racing USA DLC, as well as a massive list of changes in the new 1.2 version, got published, and oh boy, are they amazing! So in this video, I'm gonna quickly go over the new DLC and then focus more about AMS2's transformation regarding the 1.2 update. As most of you probably already know, Risa's next addition to Autumn Vista 2 in terms of purchasable content is the Racing USA pack that is planned to release in three parts, where each of them features new USA specific content. The first one just came out alongside the massive 1.2 update and includes three all new tracks as well as two new car classes. The DPI class and the more well-known GTE class featuring the Porsche 991 RSR, the BMW M8 and the Corvette C8R. To properly review all of the new tracks and do some comparisons to other sims is a bit tricky for me, as I've only ever driven on Laguna Seca but not a single lap around any of the other two circuits. So if you're only here to get some input regarding the new tracks, you're probably better off looking elsewhere. Anyway, for the one track I do have some experience on, it seems to be spot on. Everything is in place. The graphics are, as always, absolutely on point, and thanks to the new physics updates, which I will get to in a moment, the up and downhill sections, aka the corkscrew area, are a charm without any sliding whatsoever. Provided you are not going over your car's limits, of course. For the cars, it first of all has to be said that they sound amazing, especially the Corvette and the unique whine of the Porsche. I also felt like the Corvette is a bit faster than the BMW and the Porsche, but only marginally. Regarding the handling, I'd 100% recommend to give those cars a try, as they are currently the best cars in the whole game. In my opinion, they are even outclassing the GT3s and Formula 3s, which were my personal favorites, at least until today. The only negatives about the Laguna Seca are that the rolling start doesn't work properly yet, as you are forced to go over the massive curb in the last corner, which always results in some collisions before you're even in control of your car, and secondly, that the AI clips the pit wall on the starting straight from time to time. But apart from those minor issues, the Racing USA DLC can be labeled as a massive success, and if you have some money to spare, 12 euros to be more precise, you should definitely consider buying it. After going over all new additions in this update, let's focus on the actual changes in the 1.2 patch and what they could mean for Autumn Restore 2's future. With a size of roughly 6 GB, this update was by far the biggest ever released by Risa. Some of its changes, like introducing different foliages for different seasons for a few selected circuits, or allowing for real weather synchronization, which enables us to pick the actual real weather conditions for any track back to the year 1979 for any given day, are a nice to have in my opinion, and can further enhance the simulator if the basic experience, which I consider to mainly be the driving physics, are already solid. For me, ever since its release, Autumn Restore 2 always was a big step up from its predecessor, Project Cars 2, if I might label it as such. However, to compete against the big boys, namely Assetto Corsa Competizione, AC, R-Factor 2, iRacing and such, felt like quite a stretch, since the driving physics combined with really poor default setups could be a bit shady at times. Which ultimately also started off the debate about Risa's implementation of LSDs or limited slip differentials. To be fair though, solid updates polishing these things here and there were consistently released, which already is an amazing thing by itself, but the whole process felt a bit sluggish. Like, you knew the game could be shady at times, like the multiplayer rating system promised to us since release, was therefore also lacking online activity, and yet Risa seemed to just carefully take one step at a time, polishing their creation, which was incomprehensible for me, since ACC, which had similarly bad first months, almost died due to a lack of meaningful updates and partly shady physics. Now, you might say, wow, cool story bro, but what exactly does this have to do with the actual update, which you haven't really mentioned once yet? Well, to keep it short, custom championships were finally added, meaning you are now able to fully customize their car classes and tracks. There are now different sounds for locking up tires, which sound more realistic, And finally, the AI also received some love. Obviously, this is not the full list of changes, but if you're interested in reading through them, there's a link in the description. Apart from the previously mentioned changes, Risa massively fiddled with the force feedback settings, physics and default setups for all cars. And honestly, I don't care what they changed, but everything they did was a massive success. The 1.2 patch has transformed Autumn Rooster 2 into Autumn Rooster 2.5, if you will. The game simply isn't comparable to earlier states anymore. Pretty much everything I ever criticized about AMS2's physics and such doesn't exist anymore. There were instances where your tires would lock up when braking too hard in GT3 cars, causing twitchy behavior in braking zones. Gone. Bigger than average bumps could unsettle cars to a level where they would instantly spin out. Gone. In some instances, cars would sometimes end up massively under and oversteering in the same corner, which ultimately got to known as AMS2's differential problem. Gone. And the list goes on and on and on. What I'm trying to say is that this very update has boosted Autumn Rooster 2's physics and also its default setups to an unprecedented level. You see, previously you had to spend a whole lot of time to fiddle with said default setups before being able to enjoy pretty much every car. There's no need for this anymore. The cars also feel as connected to the road as never before. And the further development of the force feedback, also introduced in this patch, goes along nicely, to say the least. Lastly, I am convinced that if Risa finally managed to revive the multiplayer scene, Autumn Rooster 2 certainly has the potential to cement its newly gained spot among the big boys in the sim racing ladder. It all comes down to the next few months. If said change happens, and currently everything is going in the right direction, this game could have a similar story of success as ACC. The fundamentals are now most definitely there, and Risa even went so far as to make all DLC tracks available for everyone in the multiplayer, which means you can from now on drive every track without any limitations there. But only time will tell how this story will evolve and how they are planning to make the multiplayer more appealing. So yeah, if you enjoyed the video or got something useful out of it, you could consider subscribing to this channel for more sim racing content. Until the next one, take care.